Good morning, all of you. Let's begin. This is the question, illustration 22. Yeah, Vaishnavi. Doubt. Vaishnavi. Am I audible, everyone? Okay, yeah. Okay, let's start. I explained you yesterday that IOC is to be calculated always on. Yes.
I have a doubt in practical 21 question.
This illustration?
No, ma'am, practical.
So that you have to, I told you, you have to give me a message later on, I mean, before I start this Saturday session. Why didn't you ask me? I have to plan it na, before time. So yes, after that, I'll explain you or I'll just explain you on WhatsApp. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Let's begin with this now. I have explained yesterday that IOC should be calculated always on opening capital, and you have to be very careful regarding the dates given that capital on this day year ended or on the last 31st March 2000 whatever was the current year that year they have given. Then you have to find out the opening capital with the method I explained, reverse method, drawings added, and other gaining items you have to subtract. So another way of giving the question will be this, giving balance sheet. Now if balance sheet is given and then capitals are given here in balance sheet, that means these capitals are closing capitals, because if you see this balance sheet as at date 31st March, means this is your closing capital. So again, don't directly calculate on 90,000 and 80,000 IOC. First step will be you have to find out opening capital first. And few information is given below that balance sheet, that X drawings were 10,000, Y's were 30. And profit for the year ended was 60,000, out of which 40,000 is taken to GR, which is reflecting in balance sheet also, 40,000. So what we will do according to our method, if you see, X, they have started calculating X. X capital was 90, closing capital. Then drawings were 10, so added. Now, they have told you that profit was 60,000 and out of which 40,000 was taken to GR. That means 20,000 which was left must be distributed to partners in their ratio. Ratio is not given. That means it must be distributed equally. So 20,000, if you distribute equally, it is 10,000. So that's the reason this 10,000 is subtracted. And again, you get the opening capital is 90,000. Similarly, for Y, closing capital was 80. He withdrew 30. So we are adding 30,000 and subtracting the profit 10,000. So his opening capital for Y was 1 lakh. Now you can find out the IOC, that is on 90,000 for X and for Y, 1 lakh. Okay, so this was the final answer only, that on this you have to find out. So this is the 5,000 is your IOC for Y, and here somewhere for X is this 4,500 for X. Now, yesterday also, Harshil has asked that why, ma'am, you have not shown that profit subtracted. So you have to be very careful about this when they give the information about the profit also. that whether they have, otherwise they will give you in question that which was already distributed. If it is not mentioned that it which was already distributed, then you shouldn't give the effect for profit. Similarly, in this question also, they have not clearly given, but it is again a silent adjustment that if 60,000 was profit and 40,000 was taken to GR, that means distribution of profit to the partners must have been done. That's the reason we are passing this effect of profit. In earlier question, which I explained yesterday, in that we didn't show the effect of profit because it was given that on the last day the profit was this much and no information regarding the distribution. So any doubt? One student wants to join now. This is a problem. Next time onwards, I am not going to allow anyone to join. Get disturbed. Okay. Let's begin now. This was illustration 22. I am going to explain you now next, that is 23. This is the 23, which I could have explained you directly in the soft copy of Greval, but I have solved it with two methods. So that's the reason I'm solving it in this other slide. If you read the question, X and Y partners, ratio 3:2, and their closing capitals are given. Yeah, Dhruv. Ru has doubt. Okay, I'm moving back to the question. And their closing capitals are 10 lakhs and 12 lakhs 50. On 1st May, X has introduced 2 lakhs 50 and Y withdrew 1 lakh 25. Then again, after a few months, on 1st October, X withdrew 5 lakhs and Y introduced this much. So what you have to do is you have to find out the opening capital and give 6% interest on that. Then later on, during the year 31st March 2020, X drawings and Y drawings were 2 lakhs 50 and 1 lakh 50. So these drawings which they have given are drawings out of profit and those were drawings out of capital. And profit before IOC is given 5 lakhs. Now they have asked you to calculate the IOC in both the ways. One, if the capital methods are fixed and if the capital methods are fluctuating. So if they are fixed, I have explained yesterday the format of when they are fixed and when they are fluctuating. So the same thing we will do. If they are fixed, we don't take capital out of profit. We will just consider, withdrawing out of profit. We'll just take the withdrawal out of capital. So if we start with capitals, closing capitals, they have given were 10 lakhs and 12 lakhs 50. Now withdrawal of the capital was 5 lakhs and 1 lakh 25. Here somewhere, this is Y has withdrawn 1 lakh 25. And here X has withdrawn 5 lakhs. So we are adding that first. Then additional capital. X has brought additional capital is 2 lakhs 50. And Y has introduced 6 lakhs 25. So that we are subtracting. And now we got the capital that is 12 lakhs 50 and 7 lakhs 50. Which is your opening capital. Now what they have done in Greval. You can adopt both the methods. I'll explain you both. Even this and even what I have found out. Now, if we take about X. So, what we do for X, the beginning capital, opening capital was 12 lakh 50, which we have seen here. And for Y is 7 lakh 50. So, same thing in the beginning, if we take 12 lakh 50. So, there are two ways. Like, so as I told you, take the example of another example I'm giving, simple one, before I explain you this. Suppose the capital, they started with 2 lakhs, both of them. Now, one of them is withdrawing 1 lakh after 6 months and another is adding 1 lakh after 6 months. So, what I taught you that you can find out IOC in two slots. One, till 6 months, you will find out 2 lakhs. Another 6 months, if it was X and if he has withdrawn, then another 6 months, you will find out 1 lakh. And another method, what you can do is, first you find the interest on 2 lakhs for whole year. And then again, you find 1 lakh interest on capital 1 lakh for 6 months. And that IOC you subtract it. That is another method. So both the methods we can do this way. If you consider 12 lakhs 50 for whole year. So we are taking this 12 lakhs 50 for whole year, 75,000 you get. Then because the person has introduced 2 lakhs 50. So we are finding on interest on 2 lakhs 50, 6%. Why 11 months? Because it was which day? 1st May. If I go back to the question here, see. 1st May X introduced 2 lakhs 50. We are talking only about X just now. That means immediately after 1 month, he has brought 2 lakhs 50. That means we have to pay interest 2 lakhs 50 for next 11 months. So here we are finding only on 2 lakhs 50. And this is the interest 13,750. And then if you see on 1st October, they said another adjustment here on 1st October, X has withdrawn 5 lakhs. So again, if you calculate on 5 lakhs, then it will be 6 months from October. So interest on capital, 5 lakhs, 6%, 6 months. That we are subtracting because you have withdrawn. So first we found 75,000, then we added on additional capital, that is 13,750, and then we are subtracting on the withdrawal of capital, 15,000, and this is the digit we get. Same thing for Y also we do this. Y started with opening capital 45,000. He has additional capital he brought in October, not in May. If you see, it was a vice versa. X was introducing and Y was withdrawing. So on 1st October, X withdrew and Y introduced. So Y, we are taking it for 6 months additional capital on this much amount, that is 6 lakhs 25, 6 months, 6%, this much you get. And when he is withdrawing, that is 1 lakh 25, he is withdrawing on 1st May. So the capital has reduced since 11 months. So on 11 months, we are putting this, we are subtracting this, and you will get this digit. So this was the one method which Grewal has given. Then this method which I have explained you yesterday, both are applicable. Both even sometimes they give you this method also while explaining in books. So what I have done now, see, I started with 12 lakhs 50 because it was opening capital, 6%, and this there was no change of capital till 1st May. That means 12,50,000 was only used for 1 month. So if I find for 1 month, this is the answer, 6,000 something. Then he is introducing, X is introducing how many? 2,50,000. If you remember here, X has introduced 2,50,000 on 1st May. So now when it was 12,50,000, and if you introduce 2,50,000, it becomes 15 lakhs. So on 15 lakhs, 6%. Now this 15 lakhs continued till 1st October. That means 5 months it continued. So we have to pay interest on this 5 months. So this is the digit we get. On 1st of October, they said that X is withdrawing 5 lakhs. See here. X withdrew 5 lakhs. Now when the capital has become 15 lakhs, and from that if you withdraw 5 lakhs, it becomes 10 lakhs, and then you're using it for 6 months. So this is the IOC of remaining after the withdrawal. Then you add all these 3 and you get this digit. Similarly for Y, Y's opening capital was 7 lakh 50. Again, he is using only for 1 month. So we have found out for 1 month. Now what happens on 1st May, he is not introducing, he is withdrawing. is withdrawing 1,25,000. So we have to subtract it. In this case, in X case, we have added 2,50,000. So it became 15 lakhs. But in Y's case, he has withdrawn. So we deduce 1,25,000. Again, he is using this money in business for 5 months. On five months, we will calculate. Then on 1st October, X withdrew, but Y added. Y added how many? We have here something, 6 lakh something. This is 6,25,000 Y have introduced. So when it was 6,25,000 and when he is introducing 6,25,000, it becomes 12,50,000. And we are using it from October to March, 6 months. So we are finding the interest for 6 months. And then we add all these three and we get this digit. So if you see both the method, the final digit is same. The difference is in this method, first method, the people are not showing the calculation on the lump sum amount or added amount on grand total. They are just showing on the changes value. So if you see this 12,50,000 was the base for them. They assume that this 12,50,000 continued for whole year. Then whatever the additional, only the additional part, that is 2,50,000, they are continuing for 11 months. And here some 5 lakhs was their withdrawal that they have considered the changes for 6 months. And if it was withdrawal, then we are subtracting. And if it was additional, it is added. So this is only the difference between these two methods. Whichever you are okay, you can follow this. Any doubt in this? This is a still fixed method. Fluctuating method is left. Any doubt, anyone? I think this one is more easy for you. The second one, which I have explained, that first you continue only for what amount you are using, that is 12,50,000 for how many months, and then whatever changes are there, you go with the date. If on the first, in the beginning of the month, if there is introduction, you add for that particular month. Then again, if there is a withdrawal, you subtract for that particular period and then you add all the amounts. Okay. Now, if we go for fluctuating method. In fluctuating method, I told you, you have to show the effects of drawings from profit also. So here we start again. That closing capital were 10,00,000 and 12,50,000. Withdrawals out of capital was 5,00,000 and 1,25,000. Drawings out of profit 2,50,000 and 1,25,000. These 2,50,000 and 1,25,000 we didn't take in this method, fixed method. If you see, there was only 5,00,000 and 1,25,000, which was withdrawal out of capital. But in fluctuating, you have to consider small drawings also. So this we have drawn. Then additional capital is same for that method also. This method also, you have to subtract the additional capital. Then there was a share of profit here in the question. Last line they have given that 5,00,000 was the profit. Okay. And the ratio was this 3:2. So this was, we have to show the effect for this. Where is it? So this 3:2, you distributed 5,00,000 and then you're subtracting. Now your capital has become 12,00,000 and 6,75,000. The capital is differing. If it was a fixed method, the opening capital was 12,50,000 and 7,50,000. But if it is a fluctuating method, then we have the capital, opening capital is 12,00,000 and 6,75,000. Now again with their method, we have to start. We assume that 12,00,000 will be throughout the year for X and 6,75,000 throughout the year. So first we calculate for X 12,00,000 6% whole year, that is 72,000. Then the first May came and he is introducing. So there is a change of 2,50,000 for 11 months. So only on 2,50,000 you will find out 11 months. You'll find this. Then he is withdrawing after that on 1st October 5,00,000. So again on this 5,00,000, you are subtracting that amount because it was withdrawings and you get the net digit 70,750. Same thing for Y. Opening capital we started with 6,75,000. Whole year we are providing 40,500 is the interest. Then we are adding. His addition was not done on 1st May. You can take vice versa. Like you can take this less above and add below if you want to go by time wise. So if you go by time wise, it was 1st May first. and on 1st May he has withdrawn 1,25,000. So you can subtract this interest on 1,25,000 for 11 months first. You'll subtract 6,087,5. Then comes 1st October. In this, he has brought the additional capital, that is 6,25,000 for 6 months, 6%. So this you can add 18,750. And finally, you will get this digit. Now, if we go by that method, and now what you observe in this, that they have just considered the changes that was withdrawal out of capital, this 5 lakhs. They have not considered this 5 lakhs, they have considered here withdrawal and 1,25,000 for him. Why? They have not considered 2,50,000 and 1,25,000 while finding IOC. Because it is capital withdrawal out of profit, and we don't consider it as a change in capital. Change in capital will only be when there is a withdrawal out of capital. So these three digits, these two digits, 2,50,000 and 5 lakhs here, is same as it was in this method. If you see 2,50,000 and 5 lakhs, only the opening capital has changed. Here also opening capital has changed, but these digits are same. If you see 625 and 125. Now in this method, next method which I have done, I will start that the opening capital were now 12 lakhs and 6,75,000. And we will go date wise that the changes were made on 1st May. So 12 lakhs was utilized only for 1 month. So we are finding IOC on 12 lakhs for 1 month. Then he is adding, X is bringing 2 lakh something. So we add it and it becomes 14,50,000. And again, it is going to last only till 30 September. So 5 months. So this is the IOC on 14,50,000. Then he is withdrawing certain amount that we are subtracting. I think 5 lakhs he has withdrawn. So 5 lakhs we are subtracting and you are getting 9,50,000, which it will be used for 6 months. So this is the digit and then we add all three. Same thing for Y. It started with 675, 1 month only you have used. Then he is withdrawing. Y is withdrawing immediately after 1 month. It may be some 1,25,000 he is withdrawing, it's given. So if you deduct 1,25,000, it became 5,50,000 using for 5 months. So this is the IOC. Then on 1st October, he is introducing 650 something, the digit was 625 or something. So this is the digit after adding 11,75,000 only for 6 months. And this is the IOC. And then you add all the three. And this is the digit. Again, the answers are same if you see this and this, this and this. Now you can adopt any method which is comfortable for you. But then concentrate only on that method. Don't keep on jumping from this method to this. Then you will get confused. Whichever is easy for you, you have to adopt that. Some people will find this easy. Someone will find this easy. The only thing difference is when it is fluctuating method, the opening capital will be changed because you are going to consider this small drawings, that is drawings out of profit. Also, you are going to add 2,50,000 and 1,25,000, then opening capital changes. And here, because it was fixed method, there is no effect for withdrawing out of profit. Okay, I want all of you to give attendance. Hardly 5 minutes are left, so all of you start giving attendance and then we'll discuss any doubt about this topic. Okay, Siddharth has disconnectivity. Just a minute, Siddharth is joining back. Okay, Siddharth, you just put present ma'am in chat and then we'll continue with the topic. Any doubt, children, in this question? You can again go through it. It is not that immediately it will go into your brains. So just first you refer Grewal and then you refer my video this on YouTube and then compare it. And whichever method you want to do, you can do it. So let's go for the next question. Illustration 24, I want to explain you now from Grewal part. This is the question. XY partners ratios are given 7:3. Capitals on 1st April given. So no worries, it's opening capital only, 5 lakhs and 4 lakhs. Interest is to be given on capital 5% and drawings during the year were this much. Profit before allowing any interest to X and Y, 8 lakhs and salary to Y is 5,000 per month. That means yearly it is 60,000. And 10% of net profit is to be taken to GI. This is a simple question I have selected. And prepare PNL appro. And because they have told you capital accounts and current accounts, the reason is this why I selected. Though it is simple, PNL appro is simple. How many of you can't see screen? Is it a visible screen? Okay, then I don't know why one of the person is not able to see. It's your network problem maybe then. I'm going back. Okay, now first we will make PNL appro. As it is given 8 lakhs before anything, before any adjustment. So directly you can take 8 lakhs. Then they have told you that IOC is to be calculated 5%. So if you see 5 lakhs and 4 lakhs 5%, you get 25,000 and 20,000. And here this is very much important. What we are using is X current account and Y is current account, because it is a fixed method they have adopted. Because in question they have told you that prepare current account. You have to assume that they are following fixed capital method. So any changes will be IOC, IOD, salary, exec, etc. will be taken to current account. So we are writing current account. Then Y is salary, Y is current account, 60,000 per year we are adding here. Then 8 lakhs minus this 1,05,000. Sorry, they told you that 10% of net profit is to be taken. So 10% of 8 lakh is this 80,000. Then 8 lakhs minus all this 3-digit, you will get 6,15,000. That you have to divide in 7:3, that is 7/10 and 3/10. Then we make capital account. As you know, capital is fixed method. So the brought down will be only the carried down. So brought down always starts on the credit side because it is capital. If you remember, capital increases on credit side and decreases on debit side. So balance brought down 5 lakhs, 4 lakhs, no additional capital or no drawings from capital. So the capital will remain same 5 lakhs, 4 lakhs for closing. Now the changes which I used to tell you, it goes cross. If it is this side, it will go to capital this side. That is IOC salary will go on this side and IOD and drawings will go on this side. So, but now because it is a fixed method, we are take the effects are same, but only the account is current account. So IOC two partners, so two columns we have to make this way, x and y. Even if there was z, suppose, so three columns we will make along with the date. Then 25,000, 20,000. Y's salary, only Y is getting. So we are putting it only on Y's column, 60. And here you are putting it as dash. Then profit also, which we take here, is this 430,500 and something. Now on this side, we don't have any item IOD or which is receivable for firm. So we are not debiting it to anything. But always remember one item, as I told you earlier also, that drawings won't be there in PNL Upro. So you generally children forget to debit drawings because they are into habit of just copying from PNL Upro opposite side. So there are two items always remember in capital account which you don't find it in pre-PNL Upro. One is this balance brought down, which may come on the capital side, that is not given in PNL Upro. So remember, one side you have balance brought down to be written, and the another on debit side you may have drawings which is to be written, which may not be in PNL Upro. So one item on credit side, one item on debit side is to be written first, and then you start copying from PNL Upro, from debit to credit and credit to debit. So now all the adjustments are passed. This is your balancing figure. That means this is closing balance of partner's current account. So this much is done. Any doubt in this, children? Yeah, Irfan?
Ma'am, when there will be a capital drawings, how will be a treatment done?
Capital out of drawings? Drawings out of capital?
Because it drawings.
So it will be debited this side in this capital account. Suppose they have told that they are going to withdraw from capital 1 lakh each. So you will write here as drawings. As it is this drawings, you will write with drawings, or we write bank and you write in bracket in bank withdrawals out of capital. And then you mention 1 lakh here. And now the balance carried down will be 4 lakh and 3 lakh. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And now I'm going to the next question. Oh, now one more student has lost the contact. About 2 hours. Time is not there. Okay, same question now. Same thing is there. Only the thing is what they have given here last. 10% of divisible profit is to be set aside for general reserve. What you had in 24, they have told you 10% of NP. So directly we took easily, it was 8 lakhs, 10% we are taking 80,000. But when they say next question that 10% of divisible profit. Now divisible profit means, as I was already explained you, and then I change that 8 lakhs minus first this IOC and salary you have to show. So 8 lakhs minus 1 lakh 5,000 you will do. So you will have here one digit,